So we start off now. As I said, the objective of this small session is to demonstrate to you how I will appear to your remote center participants or Professor Sridhar Iyer will appear from here, and how you and the 50 teachers whose training you supervise, you will interact with IIT Bombay. So that's a demonstration. Just to briefly tell you, A-VIEW software that we use at the client end, you would have normally 1 or 2 Mbps of bandwidth. At IIT Bombay, which is the hub, we require a sigma bandwidth. So if 300 remote centers are connected, we need about 400-450 Mbps bandwidth, which luckily is available because we are a 1 Gbps connection on the National Knowledge Network. Now, the transmission that is done from here is done using A-VIEW. And the A-VIEW software, for those of you who have not seen who are the first time remote centers, it comes up on a screen where there is normally the video of the speaker who is speaking, but you can put that video in a corner at this hub and have a control over a what we call a whiteboard on which anything that is written here can be seen. You would have seen that when we write here. In fact, it is exactly the same gadget that we'll use. And this will be captured on A-VIEW and that will be demonstrated on whiteboard. Then on the left, we see here the list of all users. They will typically be arranged in the order of RC. If any remote center wishes to raise a question, there will be a button at the client end where you will say somebody wants to ask a question, and a question mark will appear here on our interface. Now we will scan through the question marks, but we will decide here whom we want to talk to. So verbally we will say, we'll now attend to a question from remote center 1127, over to you 1127. And when we say over to you, then you will start speaking. Now what happens, because of the delay in the network, when you speak, you don't hear from anything from here. Although we can hear you after a delay, but you don't hear any response. It is not a physical communication. 99% of the time, the teacher who asks question says hello, and then waits, does not get any response, says hello. And for next 1 minute, he keeps saying hello, hello, hello. Then we say, we can hear you, please continue. Now that he hears after 10 seconds. Then he says, oh, and then starts speaking, does not say, hear anything, again he says, hello, hello. So the protocol is, once I say over to you, that person has to start speaking. If there is any audio problem at my end, I will visually say thumbs down. If there is any audio problem at your end, you should say thumbs down. That means you cannot hear us. This is a simple protocol. It works better than any documented long procedure. So let us switch over.
Yeah, good morning, sir. Am I audible?
Good morning, Sajjan. Can you speak again?
Yeah, am I audible, sir? Good morning.
Is he audible?
Yes.
Okay. Now this should tell you that you should not do this stunt at your remote center. The audio output should go properly to a mixer and then to a amplifier so that it go to a PA system. He will explain to you. Can we make Sajjan the big screen so he's the teacher? Yes, Sajjan, please go ahead. Teach us something.
Thank you, Professor Phatak. So, good morning to all. I will explain about the A-VIEW features, new features. As you know, we will use in next workshop the new version 3.7, and there are some new features added in this version, and they are really wonderful. So first is that there is a polling option here. So in the course, if teacher wants immediate response from the group of students, as you can consider a remote center as a group of students. There are multiple remote centers will be connected in this workshop. So suppose I need a feedback from your side. There is a polling option here. We use this as a, in a clicker earlier, like the same it is. I am starting the polling. I think it is visible to you now.
Yes, we can see that. So this is a quiz that may appear on your screen.
So just you consider the remote center is a group of the students or the teachers. So the feedback of all the students, you can feed that.
So I will say from my remote center, yes. And I will submit. So please note that every remote center, when they submit, a signal comes from all 100 hubs. And all of that can be done very quickly. In fact, we get a negative list also. That's an additional feature we have asked them to build. So that I will know which centers have not said yes. And we can immediately talk to them on phone and so on.
Yes, yes. And another new feature is the video sharing option. So suppose I have hosted a video on YouTube, or I can directly upload the video in this interface. So I am taking a URL from the YouTube and I am playing the video. So I think it is visible to you, sir.
Yes.
We're going to get started. Handouts are by the door if anybody didn't pick one up. My name is Charles Leiserson. I'll be lecturing this course, this term, Introduction to Algorithms, with Eric Demain. So, in addition, this is an SMA course, a Singapore MIT Alliance.
Video, you all will get the post video there. And suppose teacher wants to upload some animations to explain better, then some animations are there also. You can upload or you can create in that Blender, that is the open source software. I have some demonstrated inbuilt samples of the 3D models, 3D model of the Akash tablet. I am rotating this in all three directions. Is it visible to you, sir?
Yes, it is visible. Sajjan, just 1 second. By the way, these animations, I showed you one animation yesterday, particularly for explaining practical sessions to students. We have found that an animation of a practical experiment, or if you are training people, for example, in workshop practice, now how to do filing or carpentry, so many things, almost all skill kind of things, you can combine an appropriate video and some animated thing. And that training becomes far more effective than any good lecture, as you would all agree. So that is possible on this A-VIEW to actually demonstrate that. Yeah, please go on.
Thanks, sir. Yeah. So another one is there is a question option here. So at your side, you can see the fourth tab from the left hand side, the question. So if you have a question, you can write there. If somebody has the same question, they can vote that question. So teacher may know that how many centers have a same question. So in the vote column, you can see how many centers voted there for that question. So you just type something.
So this is the chat window that you would have. Ordinarily, you would not like to interrupt the flow of any talk that is going on. But anything that you type on chat will come out. Of course, if 300 people simultaneously send chat messages, then there could be a problem. So you should use chat only for some important thing that you want to intervene.
So I can see that question, can you show whiteboard? So if another center also want to see the whiteboard, they can vote for it. So I can see how many votes voted for.
So for example, somebody raises a question, and the same question is of interest to say 30 remote centers. You don't have to type that in. You just have to say, I vote for this remote center. So if I vote for a question here, for example, but right now there is only one remote center. So I can't vote for myself, of course. So if there were multiple remote centers, you can see some easy user interfaces which can save time in this interaction. So Sajjan, can you please go ahead and show us the whiteboard feature by writing something there?
I'm using the whiteboard and I'm writing something here. So whatever teacher will draw board electronic whiteboard, you will see the same.
So the advantage is that many of our teachers use this whiteboard to draw line diagrams, explaining circuits, flow charts, for example. And one advantage is not only all remote centers see it, but this become part of the recording. So the subsequently, if the recorded session is reviewed by any participant, you get to see the complete written thing. Okay.
Okay. Another option is also on the slide side. So in this version, teacher can allow download option to the remote centers.
Yeah, so
I am giving download option. You can download that document, whatever I have uploaded in this interface.
So let me explain this. Ordinarily, many teachers would use some pre-prepared slides and some writing on the fly. Now these pre-prepared slides, if they become part of the video that is carried, you not only require larger bandwidth, but there is a blur because you are transmitting the video image. Now what is done is, if you have a pre-prepared deck at the hub, that is at IIT Bombay, about 10 minutes before the beginning of the session, I upload that hub on the A-VIEW server at my end. Now any remote center which connects to the hub automatically downloads that entire stack. So it is now loaded onto your PCs respectively. Now once this is downloaded at the hub, suppose I am the teacher, when I advance to the next slide, that next slide need not be physically transmitted to you. Suppose that slide is a heavy image or graphics, that slide need not transmit to you. Only the control signal is transmitted next slide. If I go back, it can go backwards. It saves time and the clarity is crystal clear because you are actually showing the original slide deck copy from your own PC onto your projector. Yes, Sajjan, please go on.
So these are the features recently added in this version. So for the remote center, we have made some changes in the necessary requirements list. So I am sharing the desktop for all of you. So is it visible, sir?
So this is the desktop sharing. All of you are aware of the desktop sharing? So whatever he does on his desktop is visible here. So what this means is, other than the slides and so on, suppose on his desktop he is running something, that becomes available here. I wanted to demonstrate how do you hand raise. So on the left hand side you will see all the remote centers which are connected. There will be 280 in our case. Now your remote center will be here. If you want to raise a hand, here is a raise hand symbol. You click on this and a question mark appears here, and the question mark appears at the teacher's interface. So now Sajjan should understand that we are raising a question. He has already selected us and now he will be answering us.
Yeah, I have selected you, sir. There is another option in, suppose you raise the hand unnecessarily, then there is a release button also at your side.
So if by mistake I have raised the hand, I can stop it. Suppose there are 5 people from my remote center who are asking me a question, I can raise hand 5 times and that count 5 will be seen there.
Like this,
we pressed it twice, so there are 2 questions. Of course, now we are forced to ask 2 questions, but we will not do that. Sajjan, thank you so much. There is one more thing that I would like to tell you. We are at one remote center and you are able to see the teacher teaching from there and yourself. Now, if somebody is sitting at another remote center in Calcutta or Chennai or something, the participants there can see both. They don't see only the teacher answering a question. They see and hear the remote center which is asking a question. They see and hear the teacher answering a question. So it is as if you are asking me a question, others are seeing both of us and others are hearing both of us. And believe me, that contributes significantly to the psychology of an imagined classroom where everybody is participating with 10,000 people. So these are some features Amruta came up with, a starting point. We have been working closely together. We have been giving them feedback because we are the largest user of that software in the country. And they are actually implementing feature by feature, and they have enriched it. All right, Sajjan, over to you. Please close down and come over here. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Now, before he comes, I would like to share a couple of things with you. One is, yesterday Professor Kandan showed you that temperature controller connected to Akash. I have a small video, and later on, Mr. Srikant Patnaik, who is a partner with Sachin, those two of them have done that, Linux on Akash. He will be taking a session after Sajjan explains these things to you. Now, I will tell you my ambition with this A-VIEW software. First of all, a major portion of this software has been developed using MHRD funding. So they have agreed to make this available free of cost to as many educational institutions as possible. Second, we have been trying to convince them to open source that software so that it can be developed around some other open source servers and so on. Today, the client runs on normal PC. You don't require any investment of additional software there, although it does require Microsoft operating system. The server, on the other hand, runs on Adobe streaming server. And that Adobe streaming server license is almost 1 lakh rupee. And if you are trying to transmit at two different bit rates, for example, depending upon different remote centers having a different capability of bandwidth, then you have to invest 2 lakh rupees on that software. This is in addition to the server that you would require. Now, I'll tell you my ambition. My ambition is practically most of the 5,000 colleges have large basic courses to be taught to 400, 500 students, just as this computer program. There are 5 teachers who are teaching that course. Now, instead of 5 teachers teaching that course and timetabling problem, etc., etc., the 5 teachers could collaborate and decide to do only one course. And that is transmitted from A-VIEW. So you designate a studio as your hub and the 5 classrooms as 5 remote centers. Now the teacher can see all 5 remote centers. We have not shown that facility, but when there are 300 remote centers, the teacher can select 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and those 6 will be perpetually visible to him. He can select anyone at any point in time. The teacher can see all of them. All of them can see the teacher. They can physically raise hand like in a classroom, and the teacher can see if there are only 5 or 6 classrooms. It could be an excellent tool to significantly improve the effectiveness of teaching learning, because then you would be able to allocate the best of your teachers even locally. The point is, to do that, you would require 5,000 licenses of the server. Now, one license is 1 lakh rupee. That is a lot of money that needs to be spent. Whether you spend it, government spends it, it's ultimately Indian money is going well. So we are now trying to work with Amruta to develop this on the RAID 5 server. Amruta has already developed a kernel version. There are some problems about scalability, and there are some problems about codecs. IIT Bombay will be resolving those issues over the next 6 months. By this year end, we are very sure that we would have an open source version to be freely used by all our engineering education, or all institutions, in fact, and everybody in the world. So that's all I wanted to say.